Hello everyone, and welcome to another Godot XR video. With Godot 4.3 around the corner, this version has many new XR improvements, and a few changes that I will go over in a number of videos. In today's video, we'll look at the changes in Passthrough. We have ensured backwards compatibility with the old approach, however in Godot 4.3, AR has been streamlined. For AR functionality, we currently have two technical approaches. The first applies to devices like the HoloLens, Magic Leap, Tilt 5 and many others, where the virtual image is projected in front of your eyes. You are seeing the real world naturally. The second applies to devices like the Quest, Vario, Lynx R1 and others, where the real world is captured with cameras and this is used as the background, with the virtual world superimposed on top of it. It is especially with these devices where potentially you as a developer had to perform extra logic. This logic is now applied by Godot automatically. We start with the project created during my Getting Started with OpenXR in Godot video. I'll put a link to that video in the description. We'll be using Godot 4.3 Dev 6 today. It is important that we use the latest Godot OpenXR Vendors plugin. At the time of making this video, the current released version is 2.04, which is too old. We'll download the correct version from the plugin's GitHub page. Currently, this is 3.00 Beta 1, but if a newer version is available, please use that. If you have an existing project with the old plugin already installed, make sure Godot is closed and delete the plugin from the add-ons folder. Now to install the new version, simply open the downloaded zip file and copy the plugin folder into your add-ons folder. When we reopen Godot, we do get a couple of errors the first time the plugin gets loaded. But those should resolve themselves, so you can ignore those. If we open up Project Settings and go to our OpenXR setting, we find a setting called Environment Blend Mode. This setting sets the default blend mode at startup, and it is this blend mode that switches us between VR and AR. The first mode is called opaque, and this is selected by default. This is our VR mode, where what we render is presented to the user fully opaque. On pass-through devices, this means we do not access our camera image. The second mode is called additive, and is an AR mode where we do not have control over the blending. This is applicable to headsets such as the HoloLens, where our virtual world is always transparent. The third mode is called alpha, and is an AR mode that allows true blending with the real world. This needs to be combined with setting the background of our viewport to transparent and using the alpha channel to govern the opacity of our virtual world. Not all headsets support all blend modes, and if the selected blend mode is not available, Godot will select the first mode supported by the headset. You will then be able to react on this in code. As we'll be switching things in code for demonstration purposes, we'll leave this setting on opaque. Certain headsets also require additional permission settings to be configured, and we find these in our export settings. Note the warning here regarding to the incorrect Android build version. We will rectify that shortly. The settings we are after can be found all the way at the bottom. At the time of making this video, these settings are only configurable for Meta devices, but this will likely change. For Meta devices, we need to pre-select whether our application will use pass-through. We can leave this on none, in which case only the opaque blend mode will function. If we set it to optional or required, the user will be informed our application uses pass-through. If optional, the user can opt out and only our opaque blend mode will function. In order for us to install the correct build templates, we simply delete the Android folder from our project. Now we can rerun the Install Android Build Templates option in our project menu. Now our warning has been cleared. Once we turn on pass-through, pretty much everything disappears, so let's create a simple object that will remain. For this, we add a mesh instance node, add a box mesh and size it up. Now we move it into place. We want the user to toggle AR on and off, so we create a simple toggle the user can touch with their hands. We start with an Area 3D node that we use to detect the user's hand touching it. This needs a collision shape. We'll use a simple box shape that we size small. Then we add a mesh instance with a box mesh of the same size. I'm adding a material here, but we'll change that later on, so I'll skip over this bit. Now we save this as a subscene. In order for our hands to be detectable by our area node, we need to add a physics body to our hands. I'm adding a static body 3D here, however, this has changed in Godot 4, and we need an animatable body 3D node instead. On this node, you also need to uncheck Sync to Physics. I will fix that off camera later on. As a collision shape, we're using a small sphere. And we repeat this for our left hand as well. We open our detector subscene and add a script to it. Next, we hook up our body enter signal by double-clicking on it in the node tab. We add a signal so we can tell our parent scene when the user toggles our state. Then we add an export variable called on to expose our state. We implement a setter here that assigns the value. And then, if we're inside the tree, call an update function. We then declare this update function and call it from our ready function. In our update function, we're going to change the material on our mesh instance, so we declare a variable for this. Here I realize that I created our material in the wrong spot. So we quickly delete the material from the mesh, and we create an overwrite material on the mesh instance. And we give it a default color. What I forget to do here is also mark this material as local to scene, which is important if you want this object to be reusable. Now we can assign our overwrite material to our local variable. Note that this is a reference, so any change to the material here will also change the material on the mesh instance. It is not a copy. Now we're going to assign the albedo color of this material. However, in order to know these colors, we will define export variables for the colors in the on state and off state. And we select the correct color depending on our on state. Now we can toggle the state based on the user's hand entering our area. However, to ensure we don't toggle repeatedly due to a shaky hand, we're going to add a timer to protect against this. We give this timer a very short duration and set it to be a one-shot timer. Next, we define a variable to track if we can toggle our state. In our body entered, we can now check if we can toggle the state, and if so, we toggle the state and we emit our signal. We then unset can toggle and start our timer. Next, we connect our timer signal and we set our toggle back to true. Note that right now, we don't do anything special to detect whether the body entering our area is actually our hand. For our demo here, this isn't important. But for a real application, you will want to protect your code against other physics bodies triggering this logic. The easiest way is to place the physics bodies on the hands and the area node into a dedicated physics layer. The other option is to mark the physics bodies on the hand in a way you can easily check for in this code. With our toggle working, we now need to react on the state changing. In our main scene, we connect our toggled signal. Here we toggle between our AR and VR mode depending on this state. We'll rename our detector node so it better represents what state we are toggling here. And we check our environment blend mode state at the start and set our toggle state accordingly. We do this by simply checking if our blend mode is not the opaque mode. Next, we'll add an onReady variable to get easy access to our environment, as we will be changing that alongside the blend mode. We'll add a function called switchToAR that will handle setting our game up for AR. This function will return a boolean set to true on success. If we have an XR interface, we'll fetch the mode supported by the XR interface. If our opaque mode is supported, we'll select that. Else, if our additive mode is supported, we'll select that. Else, we fail by returning false. If we don't have an XR interface, we also return false. If we did successfully switch our mode, we need to do a few extra steps. We make sure our viewport has a transparent background. We change the background mode on our environment to clear color. And we change our ambient light source on our environment to color. Now we can return true. Next, we create a function to switch back to VR. We again check if we have an XR interface and fetch our available modes. Now we check if our opaque mode is available, and if so, set it. If not, or if we don't have an XR interface, we return false. If we did successfully set our mode, we disable our transparent background on our viewport, set the environment background mode back to sky, and change our ambient light source to background. Because our background is set to sky, that is what it'll use. Finally, we return true. Now we can implement our toggle signal. If we toggle to on, we call switch to AR, else we call switch to VR. We can improve this a little by checking the return value, and if we return false, we update our toggle accordingly. Next, we'll test this on my Quest 3. We can see our normal environment with our sky as the background. And when I touch the toggle, we switch to pass-through mode and my very messy desk becomes visible. This is only the beginning of our AR journey. There is much more to do, such as hand tracking, markers, scene discovery, and many more things. But that is for other videos. Please leave a like if you found this content useful and consider subscribing to this channel. If you want to support me more directly, please consider becoming a member. Thank you so much to those who continue to support me in this way. See you next time!